I think one of the main hindrances, I would call it like this, what is hindering someone to get answers or to get to the methods? I think it is the lack of time that you are spending in investigating yourself. Yeah, meaning too many things nowadays are outsourced. You are outsourcing maybe your happiness to outside circumstances. You are outsourcing your health to outside circumstances. Yeah, so you are outsourcing a lot of things where we think, yeah, but they should belong into your hands. I cannot imagine somebody, this powerful nature, this force of the universe, is putting you as a human being on this earth incomplete. Meaning, incomplete to deal with the challenges that this world is going to offend you with. So what I'm talking about is, for example, the immune system. I think when you have the right methods to improve, to boost up your immune system, you can face a lot of different sicknesses by yourself. Doesn't mean that you should only rely on this, but it's already a big part that can help you. A great power lies in the ability. When you spend more time with yourself, you will realize that a lot of medicine, a lot of high technology is already embedded inside of your body, inside of yourself. Yeah, but it is like a trend anyway, that many things are outwards oriented, but which is very normal. This is what we say. In the morning when you wake up, it is something very, very natural that is happening, that you open up the eyes, you get out of the bed, and so then it starts to be normal that you are interested in what's going on out there. Which means you look at the mobile phone, you look at the television, you look outside, you listen to things that are around you. That means awareness is naturally driven outwards of you in the moment where we wake up. So it's natural. This is the natural state, like I said. If you don't pay attention, it's getting out of you. Therefore, what is it that the first step I would suggest somebody is doing, and what is also lacking nowadays, is the time that you realize this. To just realize one part of human existence, is it that our awareness is naturally being driven outwards? So, in order to create the balance, what we do with all the different types of methods is to regulate this. To regulate and keep an eye on the amount of time and on the amount of awareness that we are allowing ourselves to get lost out there. So that means, first of all, it's important that you see it on yourself first. Which means you don't turn the view out there and look out. The first thing to do is you turn around and see yourself. Because then in the moment where you are doing this, you are going to see yourself. And this is the beginning. Where once you spend time with yourself, the insight comes. Yeah, because all the time we are interested in seeing what is everything existing out there. Yeah. And it is one approach. This approach is that things are becoming even the traveling, the journey becomes quite long and quite big. The more far we go out. So it's like, first I stay inside my monastery. When I go out, I'm going to be inside this village. I go out, I'm going to be inside Germany. I go out, then I'm in Europe. I go out, then I'm on the earth, on all different continents. Then I go more out, then I'm in the solar system already. Then I go more out, then I'm in the Milky Way. then I go more out. Then you are in many different galaxies. Then you go more out. It's getting always bigger and bigger and bigger. This is also an interesting way of spending your life. Yeah. But there is one thing which not everybody is able to afford, this type of traveling. Yeah, maybe Elon Musk, he is, yeah. But not everybody has this technological and also financial capabilities to make this type of journey. But now the interesting part is that in the Asian culture, we are saying the so-called macrocosmos, that the world is always getting bigger on the one side, is actually like a mirror to the so-called microcosmos. And microcosmos means it is now not the journey where you travel outwards, it is the journey where you're traveling inwards. And instead of things becoming more big, you watch inwards, things become more fine, you become more refined. So first of all, you realize, okay, I have the body. Then you watch in. Oh, I have the skeleton. I have the muscle, the muscles. I have the fascia. I have the organs. I have all the blood vessels. I have the energy systems. And you get more deep and more deep. And there you realize also different things inside of you. You go down, maybe you meet some atoms. Inside the atoms, you have the proton, the neutron, the electron. You go even smaller, then you maybe have the quantums and the quarks. I don't know. The funny part is, on the one side it always gets smaller, on the other side it always gets bigger. But those two things still have something in common, which is, just as an example, cyclic movement seems to play a very important role. Doesn't matter in which world you are now. When you are in the outside world, yeah, our Earth is turning, yeah, we are turning around the sun, the solar system is turning, our clock is turning, a lot of things are turning, yeah, and you go down, our respiratory system is connected in a circle, let's say, the inhalation, the exhalation, our heart, how the heart is pumping the blood, let's say, through our body, is also a circular system. And the digestive system, the way how we exchange energy with our surrounding, get it to us, yeah, it's happening in cyclic movement. The atoms are moving in cyclic movements. So there is something in both of these areas that remains the same. And this is one type of, where I say, to investigate and understand the rules on which you play the chess, or on which this life is based upon. Because then things become a little bit more helpful. Because once you know that there is this cyclic movement always and always, then at the same time, you also know if you do not want to waste energy, you try to reduce, for example, the amount of linear behavior, linear movement that you are doing in this lifetime. Meaning you investigate something that ultimately anyway, bam, comes to a hard stop. Yeah, but what does this hard stop mean? It means that all the energy that you have invested on one point is just going to vanish. Yeah, but this is kind of pointless. So what is it that you can then do? Transform. That's why we call it transformation is something really important. Because transformation only means it maybe doesn't look like the initial investment of your energy. It is because this energy is able to take different forms and different shapes, but it's still the same investment from your lifetime that you gave into this life. Right now we have 8 billion people in this world. Everybody has his own ideas and his own expectations maybe. how he sees himself and what he would like to do with himself during this lifetime. So that means we have 8 billion different ideas. And one misconception maybe, or just something to meditate about, to contemplate about is, why would this world, why would this life, or even this universe, now I express it a little bit in a negative way maybe, but why should this life care about an individual's expectation about life? And now we are not just having one, we are having 8 billion individual expectations about life. But for me, in my mind, it's just like, we are talking right now about the creator of everything. The creator of the universe, the creator of the planets, of the humans, of the animals, of the plants, of all possibilities in this world. We are talking about this type of force. In comparison to the expectation of an individual human. I'm not sure who is in the more powerful position at the moment. I mean, I am sure. The thing is just, I don't think that this type of force is existing in this world in order to fulfill that individual person's expectation about life. I think it's the other way around. I think that you have been put here on this world as a small individual in order now to be open. In order to be open, in order to receive what that force has to offer you in this lifetime. Which means you are walking through this lifetime without an own idea, more or less, what to do with your life. You are open to receive what this life in a way has to offer you. And how do you know that you are getting these messages, or how do you know that you are on this path that I'm trying to at least present it a little bit graspable to you? Just imagine you are working on a project, no matter what type of project that is. You invest a lot of effort, a lot of time, and a lot of energy into this project. But no matter how hard you try, you are not succeeding somehow. Even though you watch around, other people make similar projects, but they invest way less energy than you do. But they are succeeding. Or you're already together, the third or fourth time together with a partner. The first three times you broke up because you realized there is something which apparently is not fitting. But because of your hope, you go the fourth time into this relationship. But again, you're just about to feel that something is not resonating there. And no matter how much you try, it is hard for you to make it work. And often in such situations, then you might ask, yeah, I'm working so hard, why am I not deserving finally the success of my work? Or when it comes to the partnership, why don't I deserve to have this partner, this woman or this man in my life? This is the one way how you could ask. Or you turn around and ask it in a different way. Maybe this universe doesn't want you to succeed in exactly this project. The universe wants you to succeed, but not in that project. You have disciplined your mind. You have taken your own responsibility into your hands, that the life quality, the way how you are perceiving this lifetime, it's up to you. It's up to your practice. It's not to wait until the outside circumstances and your government and this world is going to create your dream world. It's not going to happen. It's about how can you contribute? How can you, as an individual, contribute to bring out this world that you imagine how it should be? And this is how I see, for example, why I'm doing this type of work. I am trying to share out what I think is missing. And this is just for my part. I think this is missing. I want to see it more in the world, in my dream world. That's why I contribute to make this dream world now start to manifest a little bit. And this is how I think, at least for me, it's quite a fulfilling way, because I don't think, I don't wake up and like have the feeling I'm wasting my lifetime. Because this probably would be like one thing. Sometimes I think when I look into the future, one of the worst things that could ever happen is that you one time just wake up, are old already, look back at your lifetime, and then you start regretting that you didn't do something with your life. This is really something that I don't want to be in. That's why right now I'm already very careful in what do I invest my lifetime. If it's not important to me, then I don't do it. If I think it is something that gives me additional value, then I do it.
If you enjoyed the video, please consider going to mulliganbrothers.com, where you can now buy the new Inspire Change t-shirts, the LFG t-shirts, the Hardest Worker in the Room t-shirts. Everybody who's been supporting us has made this project possible and projects like this in the future possible. We cannot fly all around the world with our film crew and ourselves and do these interviews and documentaries without your support. So thank you very much. The support has been amazing and we appreciate it. Also, there is a join button down below where you can consider becoming a YouTube member of this channel by hitting that join button. Thank you very much for watching. If you want to follow us on the behind the scenes stuff of our editor at Neve Mulligan X on Instagram, or at Jordan Mulligan Brother for myself on Instagram as well, you can see what we get up to on a day-to-day basis. Thank you for watching. Have a blessed and productive day. Go inspire some change, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.